Alright, alright. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat.
503.
We are here talking about the Pac-12. Man, go check out that Oregon video. Go check out the national video. We break it all down. SEC, Big 10, Big 12, the whole thing, people. Okay, Pac-12. Had a little tough weekend, Bo.
Yeah, went 7-5.
Ouch.
I was, surprised there. Colorado, Washington, Wazoo, Arizona State, Stanford all go down. Oregon had a nice game against Eastern Washington, put up big numbers, 485 rushing yards. I thought I was impressed with Vernon Adams' first start as a Duck. They handled their first game of the season.
And I liked Oregon State's look.
Yeah.
Oregon State was impressive. I liked the second quarterback better than the first quarterback.
Yeah. Yeah.
I really liked the way that they just ran to the football. They just looked faster to me.
Yeah.
Their whole thing looked faster.
Yeah.
The way that the offense looked crisper, looked faster. The defense really was flying around.
Yeah. Oregon State was up on Weber State 26-7. Collins was 10 of 18 for 92 yards and two touchdowns. Also had 17 rushes for 152 yards.
He was really good. Well, they were also running kind of a straight-ahead option.
Yeah.
Where he was like the pitch man and the whole shebang. He was running that thing. He was tucking it.
Yep, and they held Weber State to 178 yards for the game, which is good. Of course, you should be doing that if you're a Pac-12 team.
I mean, Weber State. Idea was it was happy to see them, and I kind of thought that the American flag in the middle was corny.
I did too.
But then I also kind of thought, fuck that. Go with it, Bees. Let's go.
Yeah.
You know, why not?
Yeah.
And then the helmet, I thought that was also kind of cool.
Yeah.
I also just think it's cool that Nike had the opportunity to design something big enough, that the design logo, that you can know the outside of it, that the inside actually could be manipulated.
Yeah.
You can even put like an OSU in the middle, or you could put kind of a, you know, picture of the Beeve, campus or something. There's kind of other opportunities there.
Yeah, that
it's
is
almost a platform.
Yep. Bolden had an okay game. Villeman had 70 yards and a touchdown. They scored 13 points in the fourth quarter, so going into the fourth, it was 13-7, so it's a bit closer than you'd like.
Well,
they pull away. So.
I just think they look good enough to be able to beat Washington, and that's what I want them to be able to do, because I can't stand the fact of Washington beating them.
Yeah.
And beating us is even worse, but it's not going to happen anytime soon.
So, Washington,
so let's talk about Washington.
Goes down to Boise State, 13-16. It was tough, man. Browning was 20 of 34 with 150 yards and a pick, their true freshman quarterback. I can't put it all on them because Washington only had 29 rushing yards the whole game.
Washington looked just their whole offense. If Oregon State looked fast, Washington looked slow.
Yeah, it was
real slow.
And I kind of felt bad because I felt like Peterson wasn't really giving the kid any shots down the field.
No.
I understand you want to bring them along slowly, but at some point you got to take some shots, stretch the defense. That'll open up your running game. But without a running game, they basically teed off.
And it felt like Boise State had their ears pinned back from moment one.
Yeah.
And it kind of felt like the Oregon game up there.
Yeah, it did.
It felt like no first downs in the first half. It felt like no points. It felt like going into halftime, like, what the hell is going on here?
Yeah, they wanted to get at it. Pettis had a punt return for a touchdown, which kept Washington in it. Washington had
had
fumble recoveries, had a block punt, had every opportunity to actually go ahead in the game or even tie it.
Yep.
Late in the fourth, they had the ball in the 19, had a penalty, and then took a sack, which is, again,
brutal.
Browning's fault.
But
he should have thrown
they
it
had
away.
An opportunity to score.
Yep.
Then they had a touchdown.
Uh-huh.
Then they had an opportunity to get the field goal.
And
they missed it.
Missed the field goal. And so they end up losing.
Losing.
And
that is heartbreaking for Chris Peterson.
And it's heartbreaking for the Pac-12, too.
It is.
Obviously,
it is.
You want to see the Pac-12 well-represented. And Peterson going back to Boise State,
them to be beat up, but I wanted them to win.
Yeah.
I still wanted them to win. I still wanted to beat Boise State. I don't like Boise State more than Washington.
Exactly.
Come on.
Yeah, so that was tough.
Oh, brutal.
So another brutal, brutal game, which nobody expected, was Stanford-Northwestern.
Oh, what happened?
Stanford, 6-16, loses to Northwestern.
Oh, I watched the first half, and I was like, oh, they'll be taken over in the second half. I went down to the Duck game, and I go down to the Duck game. I'm listening on the radio. I'm like, it's going. It's over.
Stanford only managed 240 yards on offense and only 85 rushing yards for the game.
Now, sometimes that's enough for them.
It is.
But they were beaten up.
Yeah, Hogan
physically.
Hogan was getting pressured. He was getting sacked.
Oh yeah. And that was great for Northwestern.
Oh yeah, cool. You know? Big Ten. I mean, they're kind of coming back, man.
Yeah. Oh, that was harsh.
Yeah. So Northwestern had 225 rushing yards for the game. Jackson, their back, had 134 rushing yards, which is surprising because Stanford typically doesn't give up a lot of rushing yards. So not only was Hogan getting pressured and Stanford couldn't run the ball, they were getting run on, which is I don't know, man. That was tough.
So let's go to Cal because Cal won.
Yeah, dude.
And the Oregon schools won. Yeah. Out of that, everybody else in the North, we split it.
Yeah.
That's just terrible.
Well, let's talk about it is.
Because the worst
Pac-12 North,
that's the worst one of all is Washington State.
Losing to Portland State.
I mean, that is just horrible.
17-24 they lost. Washington State's quarterback Falk had 289, two touchdowns. But PSU's quarterback, this kid Kiersa, I guess.
I gotta watch that on the. Will they replay that on the Pac-12 network?
They probably will.
Because the fact that they lost, be like, man.
Yeah, maybe they won't. Because
football
of that.
In 30 minutes instead of 60.
Yeah, yeah. So, but the PSU's quarterback was running the ball all over the place, making it hard. Washington State only had 233. No, Portland State had 233 rushing yards on Washington State. So they were giving up the run, which obviously eats clock for them. And, Portland State.
Could Washington State not pass the ball? I didn't see any of that game.
No, they had a tough time because it was Portland State had the ball for so long because they were able to run clock.
Yeah.
And they couldn't catch Portland State's
Washington State. I mean, I'm watching the press conference with Mike Leach.
Yeah, oh, that'd be nasty, man.
That's absolute primetime television watching right now for me.
Yeah. So then, like you were saying, we got Cal.
So then Cal won big, but I got to talk about Cal for a little bit because Cal's interesting me.
Oh, they've got a hell of an offense, I think.
Cal is now kind of the mystery box out of the whole thing because...
Yeah, I thought Stanford was going to be the number two in the North, but, you know, I thought Cal was going
to... I don't know what to think of Cal because Cal usually always got a pretty good defense. Not great, but pretty good.
Yeah.
Good enough to keep them in it if their offense is good enough.
Yeah.
Problem is, lately, they can't score the ball. They're just pathetic on offense ever since Tedford left.
Yeah.
I think now they finally got something they can score with.
Yeah.
Problem is, I don't know if their defense is any good. I don't know enough about them.
Yeah, that's a good point.
But they just beat the hell out of whoever they played.
Yeah, 73-14 to Grambling State.
Oh, Grambling!
Yeah, Goff had 309 and three touchdowns. Lawler had three receiving touchdowns. They got two pick sixes from Walker and Downs, Cal did. So that helped with the score. It was 52-0 at half.
Yeah, it was ugly. Okay, so Cal's interesting to me, but I'm still not ready to say it's theirs. I actually still think Stanford's going to come back, not to be the number two team in the North, probably, but I still think Stanford's going to rebound and make a goddamn difficult game against us, at least.
Yeah, they will. And, I mean, honestly, what are they going to do, drop below Washington, Oregon State, and Wazoo? I mean, that's not happening. So
the idea
Stanford
is,
will be up there.
Yeah,
but.
The idea is they're pretty much fine because the North sucks outside of Oregon.
It looks that way right now. I think
and Cal and
Cal
Stanford
can put up points,
maybe.
Yeah, but...
Golly.
Yeah. So let's get to the
the
South.
Utah. Hey, I've heard people say the best... division in football.
Yeah, I could see that. I mean, Utah.
SEC West, though, man.
USC,
still, though,
UCLA, Arizona State.
LSU,
those five
Bama,
teams.
Auburn. I don't know.
Well, yeah, that's true,
that,
man.
That SEC West is the best motto, still kind of rings true.
Yeah, I think so, probably. Utah, 24-17
Utah
over Michigan.
Great. Let's talk about Utah first. It was the most exciting thing. I was looking forward to this game for like 4 months.
Yeah, Booker had a hard time getting yards on the ground, so they started feeding it to him, throwing to him out of the backfield, which opened things up. Wilson had a good game.
Wilson looked much better than he did in the last year.
Yeah.
He looked kind of like Keanu Reeves as the surfer guy before.
I am an FBI agent.
Cut his hair. Now he's on track.
Yeah. Got that. And he looked good. The defense for Utah looked pretty good.
Yes.
They got three interceptions.
Well, that
off,
defensive line looks NFL already.
Yeah.
They are heavy.
Yeah, they lost a couple guys last year to the draft, like Nate Orchard, but they're still solid.
But they have Star Tulele's brother.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Who's also named Lutele.
That's got to be fun after a few fucking...
Guinness?
Yeah, a few Guinness.
Well,
or,
anything. A few anything.
Yeah.
Prozac.
A few Kahluas.
Yeah.
So Mick Rudock from Michigan, freshman.
Okay.
Yeah, threw three interceptions, had a tough time. Looked a little unsettled, but I got to give Harbaugh a little credit. He didn't pull the freshman.
And
I think a lot of less experienced coaches would have, and that would have just devastated them.
Long term,
the
I think those interceptions become receptions, and that kid's actually a pretty good quarterback.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think so, too.
And I think you got to give credit to Utah. Those guys bounced on those plays. Those interceptions were not like just thrown up in the air and who pick them.
Yeah.
That guy, the first one, jumped right in front of the route. He saw it the whole way.
Yeah.
The second one, the guy was kind of underthrown. It was kind of thrown to him.
Yeah.
But you got to give credit where credit's due.
I agree, man. Yeah. So we also have, we'll go to the Arizona schools.
Well, let's do Arizona. Because won.
And first of all, Scooby Wright injures his knee. Has
at least
surgery.
4 months, or at least 4 weeks.
Yeah, at least 4 weeks, so we'll see what goes on with that.
But that's a knee.
Yeah, yeah, so that's not, and he, you know.
Meniscus?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. So they beat Texas San Antonio 42-32. I was a little surprised, because.
That team can play pretty well, though. They play in the Alamo Dome.
Texas San Antonio put up 525 yards on Arizona. 525,
hey, man. Hey, so did we at the end of the year, right?
Arizona had 392 yards. Solomon, 229, four touchdowns.
Again, when the defense clamps up, Arizona looks awesome. When the defense is not, Arizona looks like a
Lopez
spun.
Had a pick six for Arizona, which helps out. Jackson had 10 or 8 receptions, 101 yards, and a TD. Wilson had 97 rushing yards. Texas San Antonio... the guy put up 332 passing. And
I think they're a lot like
on.
Eastern Washington in their division.
Yeah.
They play in the Alamo Dome.
Yeah. Yeah, they wing it, man.
Yeah.
Arizona, I think, should have won more convincingly. Then again,
hey, I still think they're
win.
A great team. They're probably third in the Pac-12 South.
You see, it's tough for me with the South because I basically have SC at the top, and then I have UCLA, Utah, Arizona State. And it's kind of a pick 'em for me. Any given Saturday, one of those teams could be better than the other three.
Well, last year for me,
I have no idea how to call that.
Last year for me, each week was a new number one in the South.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to the same thing happen this year. But over time, I like Utah.
Yeah.
I like their defense, holding people accountable. I like Arizona State, even though they got washed over by the South. But I really don't know about USC. I feel like USC is good, but I feel kind of like that they're going to be overrated when Oregon gets them at the end of the year. Oregon's going to just put the hammer to them.
Yeah, yeah. Nice, dude. All right, man, so we got the Arizona State game.
Tough one.
Losing to A&M
17-38. Again, give credit where credit's due.
A&M's got some athletes, man.
Big time. And you're going down there to play it, right? You're playing in Jerry's World?
Yep, that's right. Yeah, in Texas. And Arizona State gave up 21 points in the fourth quarter. When you're playing, a quality team.
For match.
Yeah, you can't give up three touchdowns in the fourth quarter and expect to win the game.
You can't even give up three field goals in a row.
Yeah, exactly. So Murray was good for A&M because they pulled the starter, Allen, because Kenny Thrill or Kenny Hills isn't there anymore. Allen started the game for A&M.
Yeah,
they pulled him and put Murray in. Trey Carson, starting running back for A&M, looked good.
Yep.
Kirk, receiver, 106 yards, a touchdown, and a punt return for a touchdown. But Arizona State.
Now, are they in the West or the East?
I think they're in the East.
I think they're in the East as well.
Yeah.
They might be able to represent that East.
Well, I think they'll definitely jump
in Georgia.
Well, look, this is what's funny is in most polls, A&M wasn't ranked. But in one of the polls, I think it might have been the ESPN poll, they were ranked sixth in the country. So there's a lot of parity there. And so obviously
A&M.
With them beating Arizona State, they'll be in all the top 25 polls.
Oh, yeah.
But again, with the gauntlet that they have to run in that division.
Yeah, they'll get tripped. Get tripped.
I mean, last season, I think they lost like 4 of 5 in a row. Like they had a streak of 5 games that they lost 4 in a row.
Oh, man.
So, yeah, you're not – that's a tough division to pull that
off. Go check out our other video on the full national video because we'll break down that A&M. Right now, I'm going to them.
Yep. So then other games, we also had SC against Arkansas State. Kessler, 236, 4 touchdowns. Madden had 106 rush yards and a touchdown. However, they did give up 401 yards to Arkansas State, which is kind of a lot of yardage for an SEC, for a USC team to give up. And SC was only 3 of 10 on third downs against them, and third downs is going to be a pretty critical down in, for SC as they get into conference play. So they're going to have to pick up that third down conversion ratio. Otherwise, they're going to have some problems later in games.
You know what? They feel, that still doesn't feel like they're back yet. It still feels like they're light. It feels like they're
And they lost Bucky
there.
Allen to the NFL last year, so they got the new kid Madden at running back. They still have Adoree Jackson, who's an absolute stud.
Oh, they've got horses.
Yeah. So, I mean, they're almost like what we were talking about, where you got schools that they just have athletes, man.
Absolutely.
And so...
I think SC will be fine. I just don't believe the hype... long term. Yeah. I feel like they will be good. I feel like August is their best month.
Well, I don't know.
Because everybody's like, SC, it's going to be awesome.
Well, a couple years ago, SC is like ranked one in the preseason polls and didn't even finish.
But people
the top
want
25.
Them to be good so much. So August is their best month. September is like, okay, now reality is a little bit setting in. Yeah. October, and then it just kind of narrowly goes down, and maybe they're fourth place. Maybe they're first place. I don't trust Sarkisian.
Yeah.
And I really don't trust that program right now.
Well, that's what I was going to say is after Sark's comments where he was making an ass of himself at that, like, donor dinner thing.
Right.
Do you think Sark's kind of on the hot seat now where if he doesn't have a.
As long as he does right by Hayden. Because the hot seat is only Hayden.
Oh, okay.
Hayden is the only one that matters, in my opinion, because Hayden is so insulated.
Yeah.
He feels no heat.
See, because that...
There is no hot seat for him.
That was interesting to me, because I was thinking maybe Hayden, because of hiring Sark and bringing in Kiffin, would
That's
be on
the only
hot
way.
Seat.
Okay, but when Hayden gets fired, he's the first one to know about it. Because there's no hot seat there.
Yeah.
It's like he's so respected.
Yeah.
He's so admired. He's so, like, it's almost kind of like he would leave the program rather than be fired, you know, one of those plays.
Yeah.
The point is that I still think Sark's a good coach. I just don't think he is championship quality material.
Yeah.
Because he just, to me, is too frat boy. He always seems... Well, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely, man.
Where it's kind of like, he's like, hey, dude, I'm at SC. We're great. Let's go. Instead of like, we're SC. Let's be the best. That's where Pete Carroll was different. Pete Carroll was like, okay, I'm at SC. Let's be the best. I don't think other people are there. I think people are like, okay, we are SC. We are the best. Let's just roll the ball out and we'll win. I don't think that's the fact long term. Yeah. I think that other members of their own division in their conference are going to test them weekly.
Yeah. So other games, we had UCLA over Virginia, 34-16.
That was a hell of a game.
Yeah, you're mentioning the quarterback, the
freshman
Rosen.
Supposedly the number one or number two quarterback in the country.
Yeah, 28-35 for 351 and three touchdowns. Threw to 12 different receivers in that game, too, which is pretty awesome. UCLA looked
good. Again, there is a program. why couldn't we make a case for them? You know, I mean.
And, you know, honestly.
They beat USC. What, 4 years in a row now?
And you know, I think they lost some guys to the draft on defense, which hurt.
True.
But I like UCLA because they've got Perkins, a strong running back.
Mm-hmm.
My big question mark was having a brand new freshman quarterback that's replacing Hundley. And if this kid can...
He might be better than Hundley.
Yeah, he could be. If this kid puts
think Hundley was a little overrated.
Did you? Yeah, well, you know, he had a lot of competition... say the least, in the Pac-12 for attention.
Well,
so,
I just never think he lived up to the hype. I felt like maybe it could have been the team he was on, or maybe the offensive. They just felt like a sluggish offense. They didn't feel like an explosive offense with him.
Oh, yeah. No, I agree with that. Yeah.
He felt like a game manager in college.
Yeah.
You know?
So, and then we have the last game, Colorado, Hawaii, 20-28.
Literally, I didn't know this game was on, and I'm so glad I didn't, because I woke up the next morning, went to work, and my people were like, hey, man, you see that Colorado game?
Yeah.
Like, how the, what?
Yeah, and you know, I watched the game, Colorado.
I was actually kind of happy. I like Hawaii.
Yeah, Colorado was pushing Hawaii around on the field pretty well.
Sure, just couldn't score.
Yeah, just couldn't score, and so it was tough watching them lose. Liufu, 23 of 40. only 158 yards and no touchdowns and one pick. So it was kind of a sloppy game. But you get those kinds of games when you go out to Hawaii and play.
It happened. It's just it's a problem when it's the first one.
Yeah.
Now, they do get an extra game because of that Hawaii thing, so that they'll still could be bowl eligible. A lot of people were talking about them possibly being bowl eligible this year.
I thought they were a lot better this year than they were last year.
And saying 6 wins possible for them. So with that extra game, 6 wins is possible. But let's just do a little Duck time machine. 1994, the year that Duck went to the Rose Bowl, first time in all those years, they lost to Hawaii that year, second week. So things happen, you know. It's just a problem when you're trying to establish a thing and you lose the first game. Yeah. It's Mike Leach. Problem right now with Wazoo, and it's Colorado's problem right now.
Yeah,
you can't lose the first game when you're trying to build momentum.
Yeah, when you're trying to,
it's like tripping over the curb, running away. You know, it's like you're already down.
Yeah, it's like you buy a brand new pair of shoes and you scuff them on your way out the door.
It's frustrating for the fan base, for the alumni, for the boosters, for the television too. I mean. Part of the thing with this television deal is interesting in my mind because they kind of move based on the year. You know, who gets what game is kind of developed through the year. So if you're Colorado, all of a sudden right now you lost that first game, get ready for some early games, Colorado.
Yeah, you're not going to be
No parent network for you.
Yeah.
You're going to be on your own thing at 11 in the morning Pacific time.
Yep. All right, so upcoming games.
That's it. Let's do it.
All right, we got Utah versus Utah State.
Should be a wash, but Utah State is better.
Yeah. We got Oregon State at Michigan.
Okay, the game of the week in my mind.
Really?
Well, our game is obviously the game of the week because it's the national game of the week. But if I could have like a Pac-12 game of the week, it's Oregon State at Michigan. If Oregon State can go out to Michigan
sweet would that be, man?
That would be a huge banner to bring back to the Pac-12.
Yes, yeah.
At Michigan, their home opener, and again, liken it to the Michigan State game. Yeah. Pressure's on Michigan.
Oh, for sure.
They've lost their first game. Now they have their home opener. They bring in a team that they should beat. In essence, they're ranked higher than.
Yeah.
Michigan should win this game. But it's nowhere near a gimme.
Yeah, you know, I have a feeling that Michigan is just salivating going, oh, man, I can't wait till we just get a kick the shit out of Oregon State at our home opener.
I think Oregon State's going to be ready for every punch.
Yeah, I have a feeling that they could be, yeah.
And if they start the second quarterback, which they will, because that's what Gary Anderson said in the post game.
Yeah.
He's dynamic. I love the moment where Dennis Dixon runs into the end zone and the entire audience, 100,000 people, are looking in the other direction. And Dennis Dixon's over here like, I got the ball if anybody wants to. Okay, that was the very start of the Chip Kelly stuff. That was the very start of like, what's going on at Oregon? Yeah. Not only the fact of like somewhat trickery, but actually being able to like actually manhandle you and trickery at the same time.
Yeah.
You know, win by 30. I think Oregon State could set something up for this.
Yeah.
It's the coach's first year.
Yep.
It's a new opportunity.
Yeah, for both
coaches.
What
tape do you have to run on?
Yep. Yeah, exactly.
You know?
Yeah, it should be a open book.
I think it's a banner game. I actually like Oregon State by a field goal.
Good, man. That's good. I'd love to see him win.
Okay, what else we got?
A trap game. Washington versus Sacramento State. Because Sacramento State has
Washington
upset.
Wins.
Yeah.
But it's ugly.
Yeah, I can
it's
see that.
It's just ugly.
Because Sacramento
be
State has upset
a
couple of Pac-12
schools
in the last couple of years, Oregon State being one of them. And so...
no guarantee it'll happen again.
Right, but...
It's at Washington.
At Washington, yeah.
You know, UW will get that victory. I trust that they'll get that victory.
I want them to.
But it'll be ugly.
Yeah. Okay. We got Colorado versus UMass.
Got to have that one. Is that one at... Last year was at UMass.
Yeah, it's
so
at
this
Colorado.
One's at Colorado.
Yep.
In
Boulder.
Yes, they get this one. They beat UMass.
I hope so, man.
Because
again.
They should have beat them last year out there and lost.
Oh, did they really?
At the beginning of the year, I
think.
Damn,
man. Yeah. Damn.
Or they lost to Temple or one of those things out
there. I think we're going to get a real ass-kicking
Temple
here.
Temple beat Penn State.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Yeah, that's
okay.
Right, man.
Go ahead.
Washington State at Rutgers.
Okay, Rutgers I would not want to mess with. Yeah. New Jersey's finest.
New Big Ten team.
Big Ten team. Exactly. This is a big game. I think Washington State's going to lose.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. I like Rutgers this one.
Yeah, and the sad thing is that in past years, I might have actually said Washington State is going to come in and throw it 65 times. And
score 50 points.
Yeah, exactly. And Amen. Rutgers can't keep up with that pace.
There's no guarantee of that anymore.
Right.
So if Washington State scores 20 points, they lose.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. We got Cal versus San Diego State.
Love Cal right now.
Yeah.
They're just rolling. Why not?
Yeah.
Let them go undefeated in their preseason. Yep. They've got to be cupcaking it.
Yeah. Arizona at Nevada. Now, Nevada's a pass-happy team again. It's at Nevada.
At Nevada's a tough place to play.
Dude, Arizona gave up, what did I say? Like
500 yards 400, USTA.
Texas San Antonio.
UTSA.
Yeah.
Yes.
So,
I don't like the Wolfpack winning this game because I still think Arizona is pretty studly, but Arizona wins, but it's ugly.
Yeah. So USC, Idaho.
Again, that's a big game, I think, because Idaho actually plays somewhat decently in some of these games. They played, Auburn last year? I know.
I think they played, Alabama Georgia.
They played Bama or Auburn. They played one of the Alabama schools.
Or maybe they played them last week. I don't know.
They played one of the Alabama schools last week. Now, they're not doing a home-and-home with them. Bama's not coming to Iowa or Idaho. USC wins there. USC wins convincingly early on in the year. I think that USC is going to start steamrolling. It's going to build up a lot of pressure. It's going to build up kind of a media hype. Maybe they're 15-ish in the country. They face Oregon at the end of the year, right before the Civil War game, and Oregon hammers them by at least 3 touchdowns.
I like it.
Going away.
Yeah. We got UCLA at UNLV. I think that'll be
at UNLV. That's good for UNLV. I'm glad a lot of these smaller schools are hosting these bigger schools.
Yeah, that's nice for them.
That's good for them. Yeah. UCLA all day.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Stanford hosting Central Florida.
I mean, Stanford. There are very few things that I fear in life. One of them is being a player on a team that lost with a coach that's really unpredictable.
Yeah.
David Shaw seems like that coach for Stanford.
Yeah.
It seems like there's just the guys are going to get to practice on Monday, or maybe it's today. Maybe they didn't.
Yeah, they didn't. It's just today. Yeah.
Where all you just see is garbage cans. And you walk in, you're like, why are all the garbage cans here? They're like, No pads today. Just garbage cans, huh?
Yeah.
I feel like David Shaw is one of those Tiger Woods types. He just seems like a psychopath.
Yeah, I think so too.
He's so weird.
Yeah.
He's so Stanford. Yeah. Straight faced. Doesn't give you anything. Totally pissed. He's so strange.
Like a cyborg.
Totally cyborg. Oh yeah.
Then we got Arizona State and Cal Poly. Obviously, Arizona State.
But Arizona State again. I think that was really good for them to get beat by A&M. I think that they could take that loss and just reel off eight victories in a row.
There were a lot of people riding the Arizona State bandwagon
I kinda still
the
am.
Season saying they're going to be one of the 4 playoff teams.
Well, yeah. And Herb Street said it.
Yeah, and this loss to Texas A&M kind of brings them back down to earth, I think.
It does, but what if A&M's one of those teams?
Yeah, that's true.
So, again... You know, with the year that Oregon lost to LSU, and LSU was one of the best teams in the country.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got beat.
All right, so.
Yeah, check out the other videos.
Yep, we got Pac-12. We got that we just did.
And in the future, we'll try to get this under, 10 minutes.
Yeah, well, this first game of the season, we're a little excited.
Yeah. And half drunk. Me. Not him.
Not me.
Nope. Okay, people. Let's do this thing. Adios.